Hello students. So students, in the previous class in the chapter that is living things and their surrounding, we were talking about the different characteristic of the living things. In this one students, till now we had discussed about the different characteristic including the excretion and that of the reproduction. When we were talking about the excretion, actually we were discussing about the excretion done by that of the plants. What happened in case of the plants? So we have seen that plants used to exchange the gases. Exchanging of the gases that take place with the help of the stomata. Okay, so we can say that it is the stomata which help in exchanging that of the gases. So basically what happened during the daytime, it is that of the oxygen, which is what, it is a kind of a waste material. So due to the process of photosynthesis, this carbon dioxide is used up, and oxygen now, which is a waste material for the plant, they used to remove it with the help of stomata. But during the night time, when there is no sunlight and only the process of a respiration can take place, at that time oxygen is used up and the waste material is now carbon dioxide. So we can say that it is the carbon dioxide which is a kind of a waste material, and it get removed with the help of a stomata outside to the plants. Okay, so we can say that the exchange of gases take place, and here one time oxygen is a waste material and other time carbon dioxide is a waste material for it. Now students, we have also seen that the plant, they do not only excrete such kind of a material, but there are a kind of a material which plant used to store them. It's a kind of a waste material, and they used to remove whenever it is required or needed like that. And this will, while storing, you know that sorry students, you know that keeping the waste material in the body will going to harm you. It will be very toxic. But in case of the plants, it is not like that. The plants, they can store such kind of a material, such kind of a waste material. So this is what it is, actually shading of the leaves. When the leaves get dry, they get shaded off by the plant. So shading of the leaves is also a kind of excretion. Now you have seen that outer surface of the trunk is covered with the very hard and the woody part which can be easily peeled off. Actually that is the bark of the tree. So peeling of the bark is also a an example of the excretion excreted by that of the plant. Then we can also say that felling of the fruits. So when the fruits, they become ripened and they become mature, so at that time they used to fall off from the tree itself, from the plants. Okay, so we can say these are what, these are things which plant used to store it, and they used to remove it whenever it is required. Now not only this, plants also secrete some of the secretions student, including gums are there, resins are there, latex are there. Although these all comes in a waste material for the plant, but it is very useful for the human. Now then we had started and trying to understand the another one, and that was the reproduction. So what is a reproduction? So till now student, we have seen in case of the reproduction, reproduction is a process in which the we can say the living organism, they used to give birth to their young ones. Actually here we can say that addition of a new member or giving birth to a member of its own species is known as the reproduction. So here when we were talking about the reproduction, we said that different animals, they used to show the different modes of reproduction. Like if we talk about the human being or the lion or the dog or the cat or the elephant, so they used to give birth to their young ones. Okay, so we used to give birth to the kids, they used to give birth to their young ones, we can say. But you know that there are a lot of birds are there, including hen is there, including duck is there, ostrich is there. So these are what they used to lay eggs. Okay, so at first they used to lay egg and then they used to take care of the egg and finally this egg will hatch and the young one came out. So here the first method, first mode of reproduction in which the we can say that the young ones just came out from the body, and the second one, first of all egg will be laid and then from this egg the young ones came out. So this was what the different modes of the reproduction. Now, so we have seen here that for a living organism, including the animal, such kind of a reproduction is shown. What happened in case of the plants? So plants also reproduce, absolutely. You know the seeds are there, students. So when you, these seeds came from the fruits, and this fruit, these seeds will help in the growth of a new plant. So we can say that plant also reproduce, and that is why from one plant the another plant came out. Okay, so we can write it that plants also reproduce, although there are different modes of a reproduction shown by the plants also. Okay, plants also have different mode of reproduction. Plants are having different modes of reproduction. So some of the plants are there which can grow through seeds. There are plants which can grow through tubers, and there are plants which can grow through cutting. I'll tell you each one of them. So let me write it that many plants, it means most of the plants, they grow through seeds, reproduce through seeds. They used to reproduce through seeds. The second one is many plants produce seeds. We can see there are plants grow through tubers. Okay, they can also grow through tubers, as well as there are plants that can grow through cutting. Okay, so these are what, these are the different modes by which a plant can grow. We will discuss each of them one by one. Let us start with that the plant, that how the plants, they reproduce themselves through the seeds, how they grow through seeds. Okay, so let us see that many plants, they reproduce through seeds. So there are a lot of plant students which used to produce through the seeds. So when the seeds get mature, they used to germinate, and finally the root and the shoot came out from the seeds. Okay, so what happened? At first, the seed is sown in the soil. The seed is sown in the soil, and there by getting proper nutrition, seeds germinates. Seeds germinates. Okay, so seeds, they germinate. Germination leads to
to the formation of new plants.
Okay, so germination, it leads to the new plant. So basically what happened, first of all the seed is shown in the soil, and from the soil it get the proper nourishment which help it to germinate, and it germinates and then the growth of the new plant or formation of the new plant it takes place. Now basically what happened here students, that when the plant is when the seed germinates, at that time the root it came out in the downward direction and the shoot is there which goes in the upward direction. Finally the shoot again divided and formation of the branches, and then the leaves is there, then flower is there, then fruits. So likewise it used to grow and develop. Okay, what are the examples students? So wheat is there, corn is there, these all are what? Paddy is there, gram is there. They all used to grow through seeds. For example, wheat, gram, paddy is there, Bengal gram, a lot more grow through seeds. Okay, grown into seeds. Okay, so we know that we are very familiar with this topic student, in which we can say that the plants are there in which the seeds are responsible for the growth of the new plant. Now we said that not only the seeds are responsible, but there are plants which can grow from the other parts also, including the tuber or by the cutting method. Okay, so we will discuss the second one, in which some plants are there which grow through tuber. Okay, so we can write it, some plants reproduce through tubers. What is a tuber? The question arises, okay, we are all are familiar with that of the seed term, but what is a tuber? Tuber is actually a underground stem which is having the swollen base, and actually it is having a swollen base because it is there to store food in it. So tuber, we can say it is a stem part, underground stem with the swollen base having food stored in it. Okay, so thickened underground stem of the plant consisting of food in it is known as the tuber here. Now if we draw examples today, so yes, potato is a very good example which is having tuber. So it is having the swollen ends, and this swollen stem consisting of the food in it. So basically what happened, the potato are having tubers, and this tuber can be one or can be more. Okay, so basically can be one or more, it means that this consisting of a lot of buds in their body. Now these buds are only responsible for the growth of the new plant. So if suppose you have taken a potato and a bud is there which is present in that of the potato, and when you bury it deep inside, it will germinate into a new plant. Now you see here one more thing, that it is not necessary that every time you have to take one potato and germinate it, then only you will get the other potatoes. No, you can simply cut the potato into different pieces, but remember that the bud should be there with each of the pieces. Only then the potato will grow. So if bud is there and when you grow it, when you germinate it, it will grow into new plant. So this was about that how the tuber is responsible for the growth of the new plant. So we can write it here, that is, first of all we will write that what do we understand by the tuber, and then we will move forward. So you see student, a tuber is a thickened, a tuber is a thickened underground stem, thickened underground stem of a plant with the swollen, which is swollen plants, which is swollen with the stored food in it. Okay, so it is what? It is an underground stem which consisting of a food stored in it. This is what? This is the tuber, students. Okay, now potato is a stem tuber. Okay, it is also a stem tuber, and basically it is having many buds on its body. So a potato stem tuber has many buds on its body. Okay, it is having many buds on its body. Okay, and when this potato along with that of the buds is buried in the soil, they get germinated into the new potato plant. So what happened when, I'm writing it here again, when a potato tuber is planted in the soil, then all the buds of potato tuber start growing into new plants. They start growing into new plants. Okay. Now, an old potato tuber can give rise to many of the potato plant if suppose we will cut it up along with that of the buds. Okay. We can write it, an old potato can
give rise to the new plant. It can give rise to the new plants in many numbers. In more numbers, you can say. Okay.
Now, how students we can do so? That it is not necessary that all the plants, all the one of the potato tuber is germinated, but the we can cut it into the different parts along with the bud and they can grow. So we can write it that
we can even cut the potato in pieces in order to get to the new one,
in order to get the new one,
but each piece should have buds in it.
Okay, so each one of them must have a bud on it.
So a cut part of potato can grow into new plants.
So this is what students, it is that how reproduction occur into that of the plants by the help of the tuber. So we had discussed that how the reproduction occur through seeds. We have seen that how reproduction occur through the tuber. Now we will see that how reproduction occur by cutting. Okay, so now we are going to see that how do some of the plants they used to reproduce through that of the cutting methods. Okay, so there are plant students that they can grow even through the parts of the plant. Okay, so if the stem of the plant is cut and then it is grow in that of the soil, or it is planted in the soil, then it will grow into a new plant. Now here the thing which we have to keep in mind, that while doing so, always remember that the part of the stem which we are using, the cut part of the stem which we are using and use it for growing in the soil, that should consisting at least one bud. Okay, so if it is consisting of a bud in it, it will be very easy for us to grow, or it will be very easy for us to make it to grow into a new plant. Okay, so we can write it, some plant reproduce through cutting. Some of the plants, they reproduce through cutting. So, a small part of the plant, a small part of the plant which is removed by making a cut with the help of a sharp knife, is called as cutting. Okay, so it is a part of the plant which is removed with the help of the sharp knife. That is known as the cutting. Okay, so cutting, it can be any piece of the part of the plant. It can be a root, it can be a stem, anything. Okay,
cutting may be a piece of root, stem, or even leaf. Okay, stem or even leaf. Okay, but what we have to keep in our mind that while cutting, we should always take care that it must consisting of a bud in it. Okay, so if that piece of the part which we are using for the reproduction for the new plant, that part, that piece of the part of the plant must consisting of a bud in it. So the cutting should be made in such a way that there are some buds on it. There are some buds on it. Okay, so cutting we should be done in such a way that there must a bud should be remain present. Okay, now what we will do that we will take that piece of the part and we will bury it in the ground in such a way that the bud should remain at the upper part and half of the portion or the portion lower portion will remain inside to that of the soil and finally it will grow into a plant. Okay, so we can write it that a cutting of existing plant having some bud on it taken and its lower part is buried and its lower part is buried in moist soil. So cutting of existing plant having some buds on it is taken and the lower part is buried in that of the moist soil. And after few days what you will see that the cutting part will develop into a new plant. Okay. After few days the cutting develops into a new plant. Okay, so the cutting will develop into a new plant. What are the different examples, students? Sorry. So there are plants like rose is there, henna is there, then grapes are there, sugar cane is also there. These are some of the plants in which if we take a piece of that of a plant, means we will take the part of a plant also, and when we buried it in the soil, it will develop into a new plant. It will grow and develop into a new plant. So we can write it, plants such as rose, henna, then grapes, then sugar cane
is there, as well as cactus also. Okay, so plants like rose is there, henna is there, grapes is there, sugar cane is there, cactus is there. These all are the plant which used to grow through the cutting process. So this is what it is about, the reproduction, how reproduction occur in that of the animal as well as in the plants.